Hey guys, I just wanted to show you my crazy, crazy coleus. It's really gotten insane. I mean, this thing has gotten so damn big. And this is what happens when you give give houseplants advanced nutrients. It's insane. Absolutely crazy. This thing has gotten out of control. I've had to tie it up. I've actually had to tie it underneath to get it to not be so unruly. But look at the colors on this thing. I mean, there's fluorescent green, the reds. It's just gorgeous. Just a really pretty plant. It really is. And I've got so much of it, I swear. I've got so much of this plant. Wait till you see it all, guys. And it's only in this little tiny, like a 1 liter pot of can of cocoa. Yeah, it's amazing. All that in a 1 liter pot of cocoa. I've got another one over here that's even better, even bigger. Look at this guy. This guy right here is in a little solo cup, just a little solo cup. And it's got its roots all... Oh, shoot. I think I screwed it up. It's got its roots dangling down in some hydroton. Oof, I cut the bottom off of it. She doesn't want to go back in. Yeah, I screwed it up. Whoops. Okay, let's see if it'll stay now. There we go. Yeah, so this is another one, another coleus that's out of control, huge. I mean, the growth is just insane on this one as well. Look at that. Take a look at my African violets. They're all blooming. I put the peace lily up front, my Japanese maple. Those are my little aloe vera starts that I took off of my mom, my mother plant. She's huge too. I got a new cactus, and this guy's starting to flower too. Couldn't believe it. First time I've seen this cactus flower. Yeah, but African violets. I've got some pink ones, purple ones, blue ones. I've got a deep purple one over here somewhere. There it is. Deep blue. Beautiful. Another purple, pink one, whatever it is. Right there. And this is my hydroponic coleus. I'm gonna shut this off because it's too much. And this is my hydroponic coleus. That's growing in a. It's just growing in a jar. It's getting too big down here, though. If you look, there's so much. It's getting so big, and like down here, I don't think this stuff's getting any light, really. Look at all that. I can't even get it up out of there. It's just so much of it. It's too big. I'm gonna have to get rid of some of these guys. There's just too much. Got a Japanese maple. Yeah, it was under attack, and I think it was aphids or something, and then I burnt it. But she's starting to come back a little bit. I gotta get it under some artificial light so it'll start growing again. But this is the DWC one / Fogponics. The roots have really whitened up since I took out the that other Mr. Pigeon. They're doing really good. The temperature's cooled right off. They're still kind of stretchy though. The ones in the back that are the closest to the window look great. The ones that are getting the full sun are looking really good. Oop, I gotta clip that flower. Get over here. Yeah, you gotta cut these flowers off. They're really ugly too. They're not very pretty flowers, as you can see. See if I can get this thing to focus. Yeah, you can't really see it that well, but it's ugly. It's not a very pretty. It's not a very pretty flower. Yeah, this is my where I mix my newts and stuff. But yeah, this is my my setup for now. That's the mama that I got all those coleus clips from. I mean, cuttings from. That's about it for now, guys. That's my update. Oh, actually, I have one more thing to show you guys. Yeah, I've got my beans going. My beans and my my melon has actually come back to life. I've had to cut off. There was a bunch of powdery mold, powdery mildew on it. Yeah, I know. There's no. The only way to get rid of that is with some sulfur. I'd have to vaporize some sulfur. But it looks good. It's coming back, so we'll see. We'll see if I get any fruit out of it. It is starting to bloom. I mean, she does have. She's got little fruits starting there. Blossoms. 2, 3, 4. Even one right there. And then even my beans are too. If you look, there is a ton of flowers, little florets on it. I don't know if you'll be able to see them with this camera. This camera sucks. Our Droid Incredible 2, and the camera sucks on this thing. Oh man, that's heavy. Oh, it's because I just watered it. Yeah. But that's it. That's my beans. Looking pretty good. I think, anyways. I think I over-fertilized a little bit. Just a smidgen. You see, I'm starting to get a little leaf curl in that new growth there. That's alright. I'll add a little hydro rush and flush out. She's looking good. So, oh, I think that might be it. Oh, wow. Let me show you the basil really quick. Well, I'm, here's my Jessie. Hi, Jess. Hi, Jessica. Good girl. And here's the basil. My roommate's been complaining. He says it smells like cat pee. And it does. I got to admit, the basil does kind of smell like cat pee. I clipped off all the flowers, so hopefully it'll start bushing up more. Now, a lot of it, it's weird. I think I need to add some rhino skin or something, because these stems are very, very flimsy. I mean, look at this. There's like nothing to them, and they just tip right over. It's weird. Same thing with all the tops. Look at the size of these leaves, though. Some good looking basil. That one didn't look too good. I must have accidentally cut it. Ah, oh, it smells so good. It all smells so good. I love the smell of Bosnigal. My hibiscus doesn't seem to be doing too hot. We'll see what happens with her. She doesn't like the amount of light she's getting, I don't think. Nor does my, the other hibiscus, the Queen Anne's hibiscus. Plus, I think it's too much nitrogen. I mean, look how dark those leaves are. A little bit of over-fertilization. Too much love. That's what I always do. Too much love. And then I'm starting some peas. I mean, broccoli. That's what it is. I'm gonna do broc. This one's for you, man. I'm doing a NFT, I think. I'm gonna do a six inch PVC tube, and I'll put them in there and see how it goes. All right, guys, I think that's it. If there's any questions, or if you have any answers to any of my questions, I would appreciate it. All right, guys, have a good one. Peace.